morning guys. I hope you guys are safe at home, isn't it? So our previous sessions we see that by using Huygens principle, we prove the law of reflection and the law of refraction, isn't it? So from this previous sessions, say what is Huygens principle? Our state Huygens principle. Huygens principle says that every point on the wavefront is act as the source of a secondary wavelet, emanating from the point, spreading out in all directions with the speed of wave. So the point is at the point is called as the secondary wavelet, isn't it? And the source is the point source is called as the secondary wavelet. So what is Huygens principle says that? Huygens principle says that every point on the wavefront is act as the source of a secondary wavelet from which emanating from the all direction with the speed of wave. So the point is called as the source of secondary wavelet. From this point, we find that what's the purpose we learn Huygens principle? Because Huygens principle, it is used to construction of wavefront. From this Huygens principle, we learn the law of reflections or the proof of law of reflection and the proof of law of reflections using Huygens principle, isn't it? So from various sessions, we learn two important 5-mark questions: the law of reflections using Huygens principle and the law of refractions using Huygens principle. Okay, clear? Then today's session, we are going to see about interference. Okay. So what is interference? The interference is a superposition or addition of two waves. What is that? The interference is the phenomena of addition or superposition of two waves. Which produce increasing intensity at some point and decreasing intensity at some other points. That's called as a superposition interference. Okay, clear? So what is interference? Interference is the phenomena of addition or superposition of two waves, which produce increasing intensity at some point and decreasing intensity at some other point. That's called as a interference. Okay. So what is interference? The interference we already learned in 11th. Okay. In 11th lesson we learned the interference. Okay. So what is interference? The interference is the phenomena of addition or superposition of two waves, which produce increase in intensity at some point and decrease in intensity at some other point. That's called as an interference. Okay. So when a two waves moves through the particle in a medium, the resultant displacement of a particle is vector addition of displacement of individual waves. Okay. So what is that? When two waves passes through the particle in a medium, the resultant displacement of a wave is the vector addition of displacement of individual waves. Okay. While the vector addition, what is that? The resultant displacement will be maximum or minimum depending upon the phase of a wave. Okay. The resultant displacement will be maximum or minimum depends upon the phase of a wave. So say that what is interference? The phenomena of addition or superposition of two waves. What is that? The phenomena of addition or superposition of two waves, which produce increase in intensity at point and decrease in intensity at some other point. That's called as an interference. Okay. When two waves passes through the particle in a medium, the resultant displacement of a particle is vector addition of displacement of individual waves. Okay. The vector addition of displacement of individual waves. Clear? And most important thing, there is a phase difference between the displacement will be maximum or minimum depending upon the phase difference. Okay, what is that? The displacement will be maximum or minimum depending upon the phase difference. So consider your two source, for example, consider your two source, S1 and S2, producing a base. They meet at the point P. Okay, they meet at the point P. Okay, so the wavefront S1, what is that? The wavefront S1 for a time t meet at point P. The wave from the source S1 meet at the point P for a time t. And this place for this, y1 is equal to a1 into sine omega t. y1 is equal to a1 into sine omega t. y1 is equal to a1 into sine omega t. Now, the wave from S2 for a time t meet at the point P. The waveform S2 for a time t meet at the point P. The displacement y2 is equal to a2 into sine omega t plus sine omega t plus sine. So both the wave having an amplitude a1 and a2 having same angular frequency omega, but the different phase difference pi. So here A1 and A2 be the amplitudes, omega be the angular frequency, and phi be the phase difference. Okay? So say that waveform S1 meet at the point P for a time t, y1 is equal to A1 into sine omega t, and waveform S2 meet at the point P for a time t, y2 is equal to A2 into sine omega t plus phi. While A1 and A2 be the amplitude of a base, omega be the angular frequency, and phi be the phase difference between the two waves. Okay, so the total displacement, what is that? The total displacement y is equal to the superposition of vector addition of waves, so y1 plus y2. Okay, so if you substitute values, what I get up? So y is equal to a1 into sine omega t plus a2 into sine omega t plus sine. Okay, y is equal to a1 into sine omega t plus a2 into sine omega t plus sine. Okay, already we learned this expression, so we just simply write the expression. Okay, so the total displacement y is equal to a into sine omega t plus theta. So the total displacement y is equal to this one. The total displacement y is equal to a into sine omega t plus theta, where the value of a is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into cos phi. The amplitude a is equal to this, the amplitude a is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into cos phi. Okay, and the angle of theta value, the theta is equal to tan inverse of this, theta is equal to tan inverse of a2 into sine phi by A1 plus A2 into cos phi. And the angle theta is equal to tan inverse of A2 into sin phi by A1 plus A2 into cos phi. Okay? Clear? So what's the point? Consider two waves from the source S1 and S2 meet at the point P for a time t. The displacement of the first wave y1 is equal to a1 into sine omega t. The displacement of the second wave y2 is equal to a2 into sine omega t plus sine. Okay, so the total displacement y is equal to y1 plus y2. So we just add from the already we write the expression. So that already we learned the expression in previous classes. Okay, for 11th, the last lesson. For 11th lesson only, I think the 11th lesson we learned this with the expressions. Okay, y is equal to a into sine omega t plus theta. So from this, the value of a is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into cos phi, and the angle of theta is equal to tan inverse of a2 into sin phi by a1 plus a2 into cos phi. Okay, now the displacement, what is that? The resultant amplitude, what is that? The resultant, just consider this is the equation number 1. Okay, the resultant amplitude will be maximum. What is that? The resultant amplitude will be maximum for angle of, what is that? The resultant amplitude will be maximum for angle of phi is equal to 0 plus or minus 2 phi plus or minus 4 phi. Okay, so if you substitute value of cos phi, cos phi will be 1. So if you substitute, is what you get up, a max is equal to root of A1 star plus A2 star plus 2A1 A2. 2A1 A2. So what we get up? The maximum amplitude A max is equal to root of A1 plus A2 the whole square. A1 plus A2 the whole square. And the resultant amplitude will be, what is that? The resultant amplitude will be minimum. For a phase angle, phi is equal to pi plus or minus 3 pi plus or minus 5 pi. Okay, so the value of cos phi is equal to, what is the value of cos phi is equal to minus 1. You got to find the value of cos 0 is equal to 1. So if you substitute the equation over 1 minus 1 together, A minimum is equal to, what is the? A minimum is equal to root of A1 square plus A2 square minus 2A1 A2. Minus 2A1 A2. So what you get up? A minimum is equal to, what is the? A minimum is equal to root of A1 minus A2 the whole square. Clear? So the resultant displacement will be maximum, what is that? The resultant displacement will be maximum for a phase angle. Pi is equal to 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 4 pi. So cos 0 is equal to 1. So if you substitute the equation of 1 is what you get up, the maximum of A max is equal to root of A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2. So A max is equal to root of A1 plus A2 the whole square. The resultant amplitude will be minimum for a phase of pi is equal to pi, 3 pi, 5 pi. So cos phi is equal to minus 1. If you substitute that is what you get up. A minimum is equal to root of A1 square plus A2 square minus 2A1 A2. So what you get, root of A1 minus A2 the whole square. Clear? Now we go for intensity. The intensity will be, what is that? The intensity is directly proportional to square of its amplitude. What is that? The intensity is directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So if we substitute here, what is going on? The intensity will be directly proportional to, what is that? The intensity will be directly proportional to square of an amplitude means, what you get? A square is equal to, what is that? A square is equal to A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 into cos phi. Okay, so the intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So if we substitute in this formula, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus, there will be no square, so you can write root of I1 I2 into cos phi. Root of I1 I2 into cos phi. Okay. So the intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So A square is equal to A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1 A2 into cos phi. So if the substitute is what you get, then I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus 2 root of I1 I2 into cos phi. Okay. So if the phase difference phi is equal to 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 4 pi means. Okay, this corresponding to the maximum intensity, okay, which corresponding to the maximum intensity, so it's called as a constructive interference. What is that? If a phase difference will be 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 4 pi means, the intensity will be maximum. So I max is equal to I1 plus I2 plus 2 into root of I1 I2. Okay, in case if the phase difference between the two waves, what is that? If the phase difference between the two waves pi is equal to pi plus or minus 3 pi plus or minus 5 pi and those are max. Okay, so the minimum intensity I minimum is equal to I1 plus I2 minus root of I1 I2. Here the intensity is minimum, which corresponds to the minimum intensity, so that this is called as a destructive interference. So the intensity is maximum, means that it is called as a constructive interference. The intensity is minimum, then it is called as a destructive interference. Okay, clear? So what's the point? The intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So A square is equal to A1 square, A2 square plus 2A1 equal to cos phi, in which the intensity is equal to I1 plus I2 plus 2 into root of I1 equal to cos phi. Okay, so based on the phase difference, what is that? Based on the phase difference, this will be constructive interference or destructive interference. If the phase difference will be 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 4 pi and goes on means, then the intensity will be maximum. then it is called as a constructive interference. If the phase difference will be pi, k by pi by its goes on means, the intensity will be minimum, then it is called as a destructive interference. Okay, in for a case, we take a special case. We take a special case if A1 is equal to A2 is equal to E. If the amplitude of the two waves are same. If the amplitude of two waves are same means, then the equation number 1, A is equal to what you get up? Root of a square plus 2a into a into cos 1. So a square plus a square, 2a square. So what we get the a is equal to root of a square, 2a square plus 2 into a into a, 2a square cos 1. From this expression, if 2a square will be taken outside, means what we get the a is equal to root of 2a square into 1 plus cos 5. Okay, what's the value of 1 plus cos 5? 1 plus cos 5 is equal to 2 into cos 5 by 2. 1 plus cos 5 is equal to what is the? 1 plus cos 5 is equal to 2 into cos 5 by 2. So if the substitution is what we can done, a is equal to root of 2 a square into 2 cos 5 by 2. Okay. So 2 into 2, 4 a square. So the a is equal to what is the? A is equal to root of 4 a square into 4 a square into what you get done? Cos 5 by 2. 4 a square into cos 5 by 2. Okay. From this the intensity will be, we know that the intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So you can write I will be directly proportional to 4 a square cos square pi by 2. 4 a square cos square pi by 2. From this expression, the intensity I0 will be directly proportional to a square. What is that? I0 will be directly proportional to the a square. So if the substitution is what you can done, I is directly proportional to 4 I0 into cos square pi by 2. So what's the special case we taken as that? If in the amplitude of the equation will be same, a1 is equal to a2 is equal to a means, we substitute in equation number 1. So what do you get up? A is equal to root of a square plus 2 a into cos 5. So 2 a square plus 2 a square cos 5, 2 a square will be taken out, so 1 plus cos 5. 1 plus cos 5 is equal to 2 cos 5 pi by 2. So we substitute the 2 into 2, 4. So a is equal to root of 4 a square cos 5 pi by 2. We know that the intensity will be directly proportional to the square of its amplitude. So I proportional to 4 a square cos 5 pi by 2. 4 here the minimum density, the amplitude I0 will be directly proportional to the a square. So we substitute that I is proportional to 4 a square cos square pi by 2. So I is proportional to 4 I square, I0 into cos square pi by 2. So for phase angle, phi is equal to 0, 2 pi and 4 pi is boson means the maximum amplitude I max is equal to 4 I0. If pi is equal to pi, 3 pi and 5 pi is boson means I minimum is equal to 0. I minimum is equal to 0. Okay. So what are the point we learn in interference? Interference is the phenomena of additional or superposition of the two waves which produce increase in intensity at some point and decrease in intensity at some point. That's called as an interference. So when the two waves passes through the particle in a medium, the resultant displacement of a particle is vector addition of the displacement of individual waves. Vector addition of displacement of individual waves. Okay. So there will be maximum or minimum at intensity. So producing a constructive or destructive interference. So the wave from S1, consider two waves which producing from the sources S1 and S2, which means at a point B, the displacement y1 is equal to a1 into sin omega t. The wave from S2 for a time t at the point B, y2 is equal to a2 into sin omega t plus phi. So the total displacement y is equal to y1 plus y2. So if you add equation number 1 and 2, already we derived the expression in 11 classes, 11 standard. So the max, we just write the equation y is equal to a into sin omega t plus phi, and the value of a is equal to root of a1 square plus a2 square plus 2 a1 a2 into cos phi, and the value of theta is equal to tan inverse of a2 into sin phi by a1 plus a2 into cos phi. Okay. okay, when the resultant displacement will be maximum. So for phase will be phi is equal to 0, pi, 2 pi and 4 pi. We substitute, so you get the maximum amplitude when the minimum amplitude for phase angle phi is equal to pi, 3 pi, 5 pi. Because cos phi is equal to minus 1, so if you substitute that is what you get up, a1 square plus a2 square minus 2 a1 a2, so you get the value of a1 minus a2 the whole square. Then we go for intensity. So what is intensity? The intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. The intensity will be directly proportional to square of its amplitude. So we substitute here, a square is equal to a1 square plus a2 square plus 2 a1 a2 cos phi. So I is equal to I1 plus I2, 2 into, because A1 A2, so root of I1 I2 into cos phi. When, if the phase difference will be 0, 2 pi, 4 pi means, the intensity will be maximum, it is called as a constructive interference. And when the phase difference will be pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, the intensity will be minimum, then it is called as a destructive interference. Then we go for special cases, if A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A means, what you get, the amplitude A is equal to root of 4 a square into cos square 5 by 2, from this we write the amplitude. So intensity I is proportional to 4 a square into cos square 5 by 2. Then the value of a square is will be I0, so I is proportional to 4 I0 into cos 5 by 2. For a phase angle of 0, 2 by 4 pi, the maximum amplitude will be, maximum intensity will be 4 times of I0 and the minimum amplitude. For phase angle of 5, 3 by 5 by 6, the minimum intensity will be 0. Okay, so from this point we learn interference, constructive interference and the destructive interference. Okay, clear? Okay, clear? Shall we? Phase difference and the path difference. What is that? Phase difference and then the next one is the phase difference and the path difference. The next one is the phase difference and the path difference. Okay. So the phase is an angular position of vibration. What is phase? Huh? The phase is an angular position of vibration. So when the wave will be propagated, what is that? When the wave will be passes through a medium, there is a relation between the phase difference and the path difference. So what is the phase? Huh? The phase is the angular vibration of a, what is that? The phase is the angular position of vibration. What is that? The phase is an angular position of vibration. Okay? So what is phase? The phase is an angular position of vibration. In which, when a wave propagated through the medium, or when a wave passes through the medium, there is a relation between the phase difference and the path of a wave. There is a phase difference and the path of a wave. So when a wave propagated in the path of a wave, one wavelength will be corresponding to a, in the path of a wave, what is a? In the path of a wave, one wavelength will be corresponding to the integral multiple of 2 pi. One wavelength will be corresponding to the integral multiple of 2 pi. One wavelength will be corresponding to the, what is that? One wavelength will be corresponding to the phase of 2 pi. From that, if there is a relation between the phase difference and the path difference. What is that? There is a relation between the phase difference and the path difference. So what is the relation? Del is equal to lambda by 2 pi into pi. Del is equal to lambda by 2 pi into, del is equal to lambda by 2 pi into pi. From this expression, pi is equal to, what is that? Pi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into del. 2 pi by lambda into del. Okay? Clear? So what's the difference between phase difference and path difference? The phase is the angular position of vibration. What is that? The phase is the angular position of vibration. When the wave propagates, there is a relation between the phase difference and the path of a wave. In a path of a wave, the wavelength will be corresponding to the phase of what is that? The wavelength will be corresponding to the phase of 2 pi. So there is a relation, exists a relation, L is equal to lambda by 2 pi into pi. For pi is equal to 2 pi into pi, 2 pi by lambda into tau. Okay, so we know that for a constructive interference, what is the for the constructive interference? For constructive interference, the phase pi is equal to 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 4 pi. Okay, so if you start for this, if you substitute the value of phi there, means what you get done? Phi, 2 pi, 4 pi, if you substitute means what you get done? Phi is equal to 0, so del is equal to 0. If 2 pi will be such that 2 pi will be cancelled, so del equal to lambda. Then, if 4 pi will be such that means 5 pi cancel, 2 2 cancel, it gives 2 lambda. Sorry. 2 lambda in cosine. So, in general, the phase difference, what is the path difference will be integral multiple of what is the path difference will be integral multiple of wavelength. So, del is equal to n into L is equal to n into lambda. At the same time, for destructive interference, the phase phi is equal to phi plus or minus 3 pi plus or minus 5 pi is vice versa. So, in the place of phi, if you substitute the value of phi in what you get up, L is equal to lambda by 2. Okay, in the place of pi, pi pi cancels, so lambda by 2. In the place of 3 pi, if you substitute means pi pi cancels, so 3 lambda by 2. In the place of pi pi substitute, pi pi cancels, so del is equal to 5 lambda by 2. Okay, so the path difference will be half integral multiple of wavelength. What is that? The path difference will be half integral multiple of wavelength. So del is equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. Del is equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. Okay. So what's the body phase difference and part difference? There is a the phase is the angular position of vibration. When a wave passes through the medium, there is a difference between there is a relation between the phase difference and the path of wave. So when the wave will be propagating through the medium, the wavelength will be corresponding to the phase of 2 pi. So there is a relation exists between the phase difference and the path of the wave. Del is equal to lambda by 2 pi into pi. From this expression, pi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into del. So for a constructive interference, what is that? For a constructive interference, the phase phi is equal to 0 plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 5. So in the place of phi, we substitute value 0, 2 pi, 4 pi means the wavelength. The path difference del is equal to 0 to lambda to lambda. Okay, so the path difference will be integral multiple of wavelength, so del is equal to n lambda. For destructive interference, phi is equal to pi 3 pi 5 pi goes on. So if you substitute means del is equal to lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, 5 by lambda by 2. So the path difference will be half integral multiple of wavelength. Okay, so del is equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. Okay, clear? Clear. The next one is the coherent sources. Okay. Next one is coherent sources. Okay. So what is coherent source? The two sources have to be coherent. When the condition coherent means they having a they producing a waves which having a same phase, same frequency and amplitude, same waveform. Same waveform or the same amplitude. What is that? The same waveform and same amplitude means then it is called as a coherent source. So the two sources are to be coherent. If they are producing a wave, so this is one. If the two sources, if the source producing the wave, if the two sources producing the wave, they have in a same phase, same frequency or wave one, same waveform or same amplitude means, then the two sources are to be coherent sources. Okay, then the two sources are to be coherent sources. So what is coherent sources? What is mean by coherent sources? The two sources are to be coherent sources if they producing a same phase. Also producing a two waves having same phase, same frequency or the wavelength, same waveform or same amplitude, then it is called as a coherent source. Okay, then two independent monochromatic sources. What is that? Two independent monochromatic sources can never be coherent sources. Okay, can never be coherent sources because they having a same frequency and same amplitude, but they having a different phase. But they having a different phase. So the two independent monochromatic source, what is that? The two independent monochromatic source can never be coherent source. Why never be coherent source means because they having a same frequency and same waveform and same amplitude, but they have different phase. They have different phase. Okay. So why this different phase means because the atom emit light. What is that? The atom emit light produces different phase due to the thermal vibrations. What is that? The atom emit light. What is that? The atom emit light produces different phases. What is that? Different phases due to thermal vibrations. Due to thermal vibrations. Due to thermal vibration. Clear? Clear. Now, if you want to obtain the coherent sources, means what are the techniques you have to use? Means intensity of amplitude division, intensity of amplitude division, second one, waveform division, and third one, source and image. So when a light from the source, what is that? When the light will be allowed to pass on the source, what is that? If a light from the source will be allowed to pass on a partially reflecting mirror means, partially reflecting mirror means the incident ray and the light will be reflected, isn't it? So if a light will be fall on a partial reflecting mirror, when the light will be falling on the, it will be reflected. In which, as the two lightnings are attained from the same source, because this will be a source, so light will be fallen on it, it will be producing reflections and refractions, isn't it? Because it's a partial solar mirror, so it will be reflection required. This two source, for example, this reflection and refractions are producing on the same source, isn't it? So if it will be producing on the same source, means they are having a in phase and differ phase, but both they are having a same phase, okay? So both they are having a same phase, that's called as an intensity or amplitude division. So what is intensity or amplitude division? When a ray of light, what is that? When a ray of light will be fall on a partial reflecting mirror, the light will be reflected and refracted. What is that? Light will be reflection will take place simultaneously. Reflections take place simultaneously. So the two light sources are the two sources will be, or the two waveform will be produced from the same source. The two waveform will be produced from the same source. So they are having a same phase, or they are having a same phase, maybe in form or out form, but they in phase or out phase, but they are having a both, like both waveform having a same phase. That's called as an intensity or amplitude division. So what is intensity or amplitude division? When a ray of light will be passed on a partial reflecting mirror, the reflection and refractions will be take place, in which the reflected ray and the refracted rays are producing from the same source, so they are having a same phase. So it's called as an intensity or amplitude division. This is the principle that will be used for the Michelson interferometer, okay? This is the principle which is used in the Michelson interferometer. The next one is a wavefront division. Next one is a wavefront division. The wafer division is one of the important technique which is used to produce the coherent source. Okay, what is that? The wafer division is one of the important technique which is used to producing a coherent source. Considering a source which is producing a spherical wafer. Okay, from this wafer, if you choose a 2 point. S1 and S2. This 2 point will be act as the coherent source. What is that? This 2 point will be act as the coherent source which produces a if you choose consider source which producing a spherical wavefront. From this wavefront, if we choosing a 2 point, S1 and S2, these 2 points are will be act as the source of a coherent source. This 2 point will be act as the source of a coherent source. So considering a source which producing a spherical wavefront, from this point, if we choose on the 2 points, what is that? If we choose on the 2 point, then this 2 point will be act as the coherent source. Okay, this is the principle. What is that? This is the principle which is used for the Young's double slit experiment. Okay, this is the principle which is used for the Young's double slit experiment. The third one is the source and images. Okay, source and images. From the source of images, what is that? From the source of images, in this method, the source and images, what is that? The source or images, both will act as the, what is that? Both will act as the coherent source. Both will act as the two coherent sources. Okay, both will act as the set of coherent sources in which the Fresnel's biprism, what is that? The Fresnel's biprism in which the two source and the virtual images, which is act as the, what is that? The source and the two virtual images, what is that? The two virtual sources, what is that? The two virtual sources, what is that? The two virtual sources, which is act as the coherent sources, at the same time, the last in the, what is that? For real layers, the source and virtual image will be act as the two coherent sources. Okay. So what is coherent sources? In the two sources is having the same phase, same frequency, same form or the wavelength, and the same amplitude, then it is called as the coherent sources. The two monochromatic sources can never be coherent sources. Why this means? Because they are having the same form and same waveform and same frequency, but they are having a different phase. Why it is having different phases means? The atom emit light due to the phase difference. Atom emit lights having a phase difference due to thermal vibrations. Then, what are the technique to produce the coherent sources? Intensity or amplitude divisions, wavefront division, and source and images. Intensity or amplitude division in which an array of light will be found in a partially reflecting mirror, the reflections will be diffraction and reflections will be take place simultaneously. In which the two rays will be produced from the same source, so they have on the same phase, so these two sources will be act as the coherent sources. The next one is the wavefront division, in which the point source is producing a spherical wavefront. From this spherical wavefront, if we choose any 2 point, then this 2 point will be act as the coherent sources. Then, for third one, source and images, for some cases, the source and virtual images will be act as the two coherent sources. For persons by prism, two virtual images will be act as the coherent sources, and loyal the source and virtual image will be act as the coherent sources. Okay, so for this session, we learn about the interference and explain the interference. The next we learn the relation between the phase difference and path difference. The next we learn the coherent sources. What is the coherent sources? Why two monochromatic sources cannot be coherent? Then what are the technique to produce the coherent sources? From this intensity, wavefront division, and the source and images. So I hope you understand the sessions. You must still learn clearly, okay? For next week, you are going to write the half-hour examination, so you should be learn very clearly, okay? Thank you.